Hello, and welcome to day 10 of the 15-day meditation challenge brought to you by Choe Khor Sum Ling, the FPMT Center in Bangalore, India. My name is Tenzin Namjong, and I hope all of you by now have built a bit of momentum to your daily practice. So now we'll continue with some additional instructions for our meditation. So first, we just take a brief moment to adjust our motivation, thinking that we're going to do this meditation here today so that we can continue to develop our minds so we can be of more and more benefit to ourselves and others. And then we start in the usual way, getting into a good meditation posture. So remember to have a straight back, no slouching over. And then again, just allowing ourselves to connect with the present moment. And we do that by connecting with the sensations in the body. Remembering that our thoughts can flow from the past to the future and in all directions, but our body and our sensations in the body are only in the present moment. So just develop that sense that now you're sitting. How do you know that you're sitting now as opposed to standing, walking, or lying down? Maybe you can feel the weight of your body on the cushion or your chair. And then let's continue with a quick body scan. Again, from head to toe. Just working down at your own pace, trying to identify any areas of tension. So remember, especially in the face, all these little muscles we have, sometimes we are flexing them, clenching them. Just really soften all those muscles, especially around the eyes. And then continue on down through the rest of your body at your own pace. Remembering at each part of the body to first identify what the reality of the sensations are, and then to release and relax in a more active way. Okay, and now we'll continue with the breath. So again, we can start by taking three intentionally deep, long, luxurious breaths. So as you inhale, really feel the abdomen expanding, feel the lungs filling with air. And then when you release the breath, try to exhale completely. Then breathe in again, feeling the expansion, filling the lungs with air. and release. Last time, and release. Now we resume with the natural breath as it is, very effortless, without trying to control the breath in any way. Just let it settle into a very natural rhythm on its own. And as we do this, then first we'll just focus on the entire range of sensations in the body as we breathe in and out. So again, wherever it's manifesting most clearly to you, the abdomen expanding and contracting. Maybe you feel it in the chest or in the nostril area. So again, just try to focus on how do you know that you're breathing right now? What sensations are manifesting that give you that clue, that give you that awareness? And now, since we've been doing this practice for a few days now, I want to take us to the next sort of level in the practice. So we'll sharpen and narrow down our area of focus from the entire range of motion in the breath to just the rising and falling of the abdomen. So place your mind's attention there. Again, just with a natural breath, but try to notice how as you inhale, the abdomen expands. As you inhale, it contracts. And try to watch really closely, trying to see, maybe you can notice what's the first part of the abdomen that moves. What parts of your skin come into contact with your clothing? So again, if you have been using the method of counting the breaths, you can continue with that, counting the exhalations. If you're not, that's also okay. And whether or not you're counting, remember, whatever other appearances might happen to the mind, be they sounds, or different thoughts, don't engage with them. Sometimes when we meditate and we can hear the crickets outside, even that noise, it doesn't disturb our meditation. We can be aware, but we just let it be. So in the same way, the thoughts that arise is just like the noise of the cricket. If we don't engage with these thoughts, they don't have the power to pull us away from the object of meditation. And therefore we can remain in a peaceful, balanced state of mind. But even as we try not to get caught up in the thoughts, if we do notice that we have gotten carried away, that's also okay. Just very gently, with a bit of sense of humor, not beating ourselves up, not criticizing ourselves for being a bad meditator. Just when we notice that our mind has wandered off, then, like training a puppy, just gently bringing the puppy back. Bring our mind back to the object of meditation, the breath, and start again. In this type of meditation, we're trying to, yes, remain focused, but we're also trying to work on this faculty of mind called introspection, or shishin, which is a sort of internal quality control of our meditation practice, one part of the mind looking at the mind itself and seeing whether we're still concentrating on our object of meditation, the breath, whether we're getting drowsy, so even if we get distracted from the breath, when we notice it, then we can come back to the breath. So we're actually building up an important skill of introspection. So just continue in this way for the rest of the session. And again, remembering using the out-breaths, the exhalations, to not only let go and release the breath, but also if these different thoughts are coming. And every time we inhale, we can use it to conjure up our awareness, make it more sharp, make it more refined, so that with every breath we get progressively more relaxed. We're letting go more and more, but also our focus is getting sharp and single-pointed on the object. So gently come out of the meditation. So I wanted to just say that there's a saying that what we do outside of the meditation session is more important than what we do inside the meditation session. So I would encourage you, although we have our formal seated practice, then, you know, throughout the day, you can try to reconnect with the body, reconnect with the breath, and especially a few times you can check to see if those facial muscles are squinting or clenched, and just become mindful of what you're doing throughout the day. Okay, so let's end our session with a brief dedication. So due to the positive energy that we've created in our time here today, then may we and all the living beings quickly be able to be free of all of their suffering and the causes of suffering, and abide in the peerless state of complete and total happiness forever. Okay, thank you very much. Remember, let's keep going with our daily practice. There's only 5 more days left. So thank you all for your efforts, and I will see you in a few days. Thank you very much. Be well.